Hey Scorpio, and welcome to your monthly love tarot messages here. We're going to take a look at the messages that are coming in for you in relation to love and romance this month. As always, guys, these messages are general, so please just keep that in mind. If you're after a personal tarot reading with myself, please feel free to reach out and inquire. I will list my email address below. So these messages, once again, are intended for Scorpios, Ascendant, Sun, Moon, Venus, Rising, and those cross-watching as well. Let's see what the cards are predicting for you in terms of love and romance. Okay. Okay, so it's going to be an interesting month because I feel like there's something here that, there's something here that I feel like might fall, come apart for a lot of you Scorpios this month, okay? A relationship, a romantic connection, something here comes to light, okay? But it's not, I feel like it's not that bad, despite the dark energy of the Tower card, despite, you know, the nerving imagery here. I feel like the reason why it happens is because a connection, okay, a romantic connection here or a friendship is built on false structures. So the Tower is also known to be a tower of illusion. So for a lot of you, maybe you weren't aware, but a relationship here might have been built upon a foundational structure of illusions, okay? So a person may not be whom you thought they were, you know, the connection may not be what you thought it was. So something here comes apart completely. The good news is for some of you Scorpios, I feel like because it comes apart, there's an opportunity for you to rebuild the situation, okay? Because, you know, the way that I see it with the Tower moment, you will be sometime throughout the month, you will be Scorpio under the influence of the Tower moment, whether it's in romantic connections, in relationships, long-term, short-term relationships, something comes apart here, okay? Could even extend to friendships or even business as well, guys, but I feel like the reason why it comes apart is because this very connection or this very person's energy was not strong enough to withstand the storm, okay? The foundational structure was a little faulty. Notice how it's sort of eroding down the bottom here. So, you know, it may have been outdated. The materials here may not have been strong enough. So the storm, or rather the Tower here card, it gives you an opportunity, okay? It sort of cleanses and takes away any false structures or any illusions, and it's saying here, fix this, okay? Here, you know, I'm going to give you the material, you know, lay yourself a healthier foundation structure, one that won't crumble, you know, one that will withstand and endure the storm. So that's the beauty. For some of you, you get to, you know, clear the air here, okay? Yes, something is going to get exposed. Something is going to come to light. Yes, it's going to be painful. It's going to be uncomfortable. It's going to be unsettling. Yes, 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 okay? But I feel like it comes apart so it can come better together. So for a lot of you Scorpios, this is what I see, okay? You'll have an opportunity to rebuild a connection. So for as painful and as uncomfortable and as heavy of an energy this is, I feel like it really serves a good purpose in the end because it's your opportunity to do things bigger, better, to do it right here, okay? With the Nine of Cups, I feel like for a lot of you, and because this is your energy, you're coming up as the Nine of Cups, you're in a very powerful manifesting mode here. So for a lot of you, I feel like really watch your thoughts and really watch the intentions that you put out into the universe, because essentially this is what you're attracting in return, okay? The universe doesn't always respond to, you know, words, okay, what it is that we say. It responds to a vibrational frequencies, your vibrations here. So, you know, it's important to watch how you feel, okay? When you're trying to manifest a person or trying to manifest a certain situation, okay? If you're in a bad energy and you're trying to manifest, you know, that ideal partner or that ideal relationship, you know, you're, because of your energy field, because of that vibrational frequency, you're not gonna manifest that ideal partnership purely because of that energy field, okay? Maybe some of you, you know, are in an energy field where you feel like you're, you know, you don't deserve it, you're not deserving of this partnership even though you want it. See how that's contradicting, that's in conflict with what it is that you want. What you want and how you feel about it need to be in alignment. And only when those two are in alignment can you truly manifest your desires, your wishes. So for a lot of you, yes, a wish is going to come true for you. You know, plural, you could have several wishes that can come true for you this month. And try it, because I feel like the more you practice, the better you get at it. But for a lot of you, it's important to know that, you can't just order from the catalog of the universe, sit back and go, okay, well, I'm not going to do all the work. I want this, this, this. I want that person. I want this relationship. But you don't really believe it. You don't really believe you deserve it. Or you don't really have faith in that. That's not happening. So for a lot of you, yes, you will have the opportunity to order several wishes, several desires from the catalog of the universe, but you need to be in alignment with your wishes and desires, okay? Because if you won't, if you're not, it won't manifest to you guys. You have an energy around you who's not willing to talk, from what I can see, okay? Some of you, do not force this person. The worst thing you can do is try and put pressure on them and get them to respond, try and put pressure on them and get them to give you that answer that you're seeking, okay? This person, I feel like, wants to cool things with you, or this person wants to distance themselves away from you. That's okay. If someone doesn't see the value of your presence, maybe they're going to notice your absence here, because I feel like there's someone here. The worst thing you can do, Scorpio, is try to... If this person steps back, it's not your time to lean forward, okay? Because if you do, I feel like that's going to push this person further away. Because their energy is coming up as a little bit of blocked, especially if you're dealing with an air sign here, okay? Two of Swords and then Page of Swords, okay? Air signs can be a bit of a flighty nature. They are ruled by the element of air, think wind. It almost happens instantaneously. So yes, this person is a little bit of a fickle energy. I don't think that they know what they want, okay? I feel like they're a bit of a scattered energy, and that's okay. Once they make up their mind about a situation, and once they see that you're doing good without them and you're doing you, and you don't need to rely on anyone else for your happiness, that's going to make them come, circle back around. So when they pull back, do not lean forward, okay? It is not your time to lean forward. Play it cool, okay? I'm not saying play mind games, but play it cool. It's your time to focus on you here. For some of you, I feel like there's something here that's holding you back. There's some sort of, I'm seeing fears here or anxieties, or it could be the individual, like the fears and anxieties that hold this individual's energy back. Again, if they don't, that's something that they'll have to work through and something that they'll have to confront individually. Yes, you can help them, but I feel like it's something that they need to do on their own as well. So only when I feel like this person sort of is willing, to do that and confront those, issues, I feel like then they'll be a little bit more open-minded and a little bit more receptive here. Your strength is going to be tested, I feel like, several times this month, okay? Someone could be testing your patience, someone he pulls away, a connection, he could be testing your strength here, your strength of character, your mental resilience here. Know that whatever it is that you're going through, any turbulency, any emotional turmoil that you're dealing with, Scorpio, ultimately it's not to weaken you, it's to strengthen you, okay? You become stronger because of the things that you go through, and the mistakes that you make and the experiences that you learn from. So everything around you is not weakening you. On the contrary, it's making you a lot more stronger, and it's preparing you for, new relationships. So it's preparing you for ways on how you can sort of tackle any upcoming challenges, okay? So yes, the glass is half empty, but it's also half full. It's all about, what you look at that matters, right? Seven of Pentacles, I feel like there is something coming to fruition for you here, but the message that I get for you, Scorpio, here is be patient, because I feel like something here might finally manifest or might finally happen towards the end of the month. Or it could also be like 7 weeks from the reading here. But I feel like this is someone or something that you've put in so much energy to, towards and into, and some of you are just on the verge of giving up because you feel like, okay, I've done this, I can't do this anymore. I've given this person too much of my time and energy and I'm just not getting anything back. Don't give up, because I feel like you're inches away from a breakthrough. You're inches away from seeing results. So, don't stop loving this person just because you're not seeing the results that you want. Or don't stop, putting in all your hard work and all your efforts just because those results, haven't sprung forth. Success doesn't happen overnight, okay? It's years and years and years of hard work behind the curtain. So whatever this is for you, don't give up, because you are so, 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 so close to it, Scorpio. You're so close to manifesting. You're so close to yielding those positive results that you want, because you've put in all the work, okay? Seven of Pentacles is about the long-term benefits. A watched pot never boils. Therefore, put in all the work and continue to put in the work, whatever this is for your relationship, a partnership, a project, and I feel like it will happen. It will happen. It has to happen. Such is the law of nature. All right, guys, and these are your messages. Thank you as always for watching, listening. For those of you interested in a personal reading, feel free to reach out. I will be sharing with you more tarot love messages, guys. So stay tuned. Bye for now.